It's an unprecedented move. Metro, closing down the entire subway system in the middle of the work week. But that's just what happened Wednesday. It follows a fire at the McPherson Square station Monday. A fire blamed on the third rail jumper cables. And commuters were left scrambling for alternative ways to get to their destinations.
Tomorrow, I'm not really sure yet how I'm gonna get to class. I haven't talked to my friends regarding that because I just found out about it about 2 hours ago. So I need to figure that out.
During the shutdown, Metro checked 600 underground electrical cables and their insulating boots. Inspectors made their way through an estimated 100 miles of tunnels in order to check the condition of each and every cable.
I just wish they would rebuild the system section by section, instead of just doing these patch fixes.
Uber geared up to help relieve some of the challenges commuters would face during the time Metro would be out of service.
We were surprised like everyone else, but thankfully, you know, we have a great team here, and folks have been working around the clock to ensure that we could be a reliable option for folks.
And Uber's local general manager, Sahara Washington, says things were popping for them all day.
We did see record demand, and we also saw nearly a 70% increase in the number of people that signed up in the past 24 hours for the app.
Metro says the check of the system found 26 cable defects, with 8 still in need of repairs. The subway is expected to be up and running Thursday morning, providing service again to the 700,000 riders who travel on it daily. In Washington, Brianna Hurwitz, CNS TV.